The stage is yours.
Okay, thank you. So,
a full screen, yes, okay. My colleague is saying everything is fine. Screen. Yeah, sorry.
Perfect. Okay, hello to everybody, good afternoon. I'm very happy to be here with you in order to share my experience, Nestlé experience in the diversity inclusion journey. In my opinion, a journey sometimes difficult, but very important and very effective for the people, but also for the company, for the business, and a journey in particular rewarding for all the people who work on it. My role in Nestlé is responsible for leadership development and team effectiveness, and also for all diversity inclusion initiatives in the Italian market. Why these two roles, team effectiveness and diversity inclusion? Because when we talk about put people together, make people work well together, we have to consider diversity. And we have to have all the people on board and the contribution from everybody independently from diversity, but thanks to their diversity. Why Nestlé has chosen to diversity inclusion as one of its own priorities? This picture can give you an idea. Nestlé is present with its offices, factories, boutiques, warehouses all over the world, in almost all the countries in the world. We have more than 300,000 employees in several countries, and we sell our products everywhere. So for Nestlé, diversity, it's a topic. Diversity, Nestlé is driven by its purpose and a long list of principles and values. The first one is that includes all the others is respect. Respect for ourselves, respect for others, respect for diversity, and respect for the planet, for the future. So diversity is a topic. And Nestlé has chosen diversity as a priority for two main reasons. The first one is because the inclusion is the right thing to do. It's ethically correct to include everybody, because if we think that it's totally incorrect, exclude systematically someone, we can say the contrary, you know? And then because the second one is a business reason, we sell our product everywhere, around the globe, we are present around the globe. So we have to represent inside our company the diversity that we meet outside in our market between our consumers. Okay, let me talk about our diversity inclusion journey. When we talk about in Nestlé about diversity inclusion, we are talking about these three different steps. The first one is understanding diversity, the difference that are present in our company. It's an exercise of building awareness and self-awareness. And the second one is consists in accepting differences. Also, Nestlé has invested a lot in training and initiative in order to understand, recognize our biases and breaking down when it's needed. The third one is the inclusion that consists in having everybody on board, having the contribution of all the people, involve all the people in order to achieve our goals, our results. So it's a matter of performance. We have a claim, we have a sort of slogan in Nestlé, diversity is a fact, is a reality. What we can do is to include diversity, and inclusion in this case is a choice. And it's a choice that we have to make daily in everything we do. I want to share the next experience about diversity inclusion. Try to add what my colleague before has said, because we have several points of contact with Tim, of course. I want to focus on an experience about the engagement of the people in the diversity inclusion journey. I want to speak about what we call in Nestle emotional communities. Probably you know emotional communities as ERG, employee resource groups, or employees networks, that are voluntary employee-led groups whose aim to foster a diverse, inclusive workplace. We have at the moment 12 emotional communities. You can see the logo below in the slide. They cover all the aspects of the life of the people life, and they involved more than 100 employees that actively involved in organizing initiative events and so on, and also pushing the company to do things from a diverse and inclusive point of view. We have 16 sponsors from senior managers and more or less 1,000 employees, followers of these communities on workplace, but also in all the initiatives that they planned. A little bit of story. The first communities were born more or less 10 years ago, when we had the need to review our welfare and well-being system, and we asked to the people what they need. In that time, the first community were born, for example, a women community, young community, parenting community. Then when Nestlé, a few years later, embraced diversity inclusion, other community born and be active in the organization. The first goal for the community is to create connection, internal connection, and promote engagement, and also external connection. All the community has a point of an external point of contact, an association, an institution, other companies, and the people that participate, that work on top of their job in the community, can build new competencies and to improve in order to improve their performance at work. Emotional communities, the ERG, has a big role and a big impact in enhance the cultural transformation. They work in several aspects of cultural transformation, for example, inclusive communications, and they project and deliver some trainings about diversity and inclusion. So what we say, always say, that emotional communities for us is a win-win-win battle, because it's win for the people involved, because they create inclusion, pride and membership, engagement, well-being, leadership and personal growth, sense of responsibility, entrepreneurial spirit. But it's a win also for Nestle, for the company, because it's a way how to develop people have to a better performance. Is also a point of reputation, attractiveness of talent, retention, and so on. But it's a win battle also for the society, because the most part of this community, through they work, the initiative, have an impact of also in the society. four success stories from communities. I want to highlight the main one, maybe LGBT community that we are also, Nestle is a sponsor of Milan Pride. And what LGBT community did is to push our marketing in order to think some brand initiatives, rainbow brand initiatives during the Pride Month. For example, a special package or a trial initiatives during the Pride. But initiatives from community are several of different types. And for example, we have a library community that is strange when we talk about diversity inclusion. But if we think the main diversity that we have to manage every day is the diversity of thoughts. When we build our way of thinking, reading, for example, reading book. So we have a library internal in Nestle, and the person who work in library management is a person from a prison, because we start a collaboration with a prison in Milan in order to give our contribution in the recovery of this person. Communities had also an important role during the COVID emergency. For example, the community manager one monthly meeting virtual that is an opportunity for the people to be connected. The parenting community asked for have a emotional intelligence virtual training for parents during the COVID emergency with kids. Were at home. Multicultural community supports integration of foreigner employee. Community young supports the newcomers onboarding. Gender balance community launch a local mentoring program on gender balance. We have a volunteering community that is committed in several initiatives, and community LGBT last year. There wasn't the Pride in Milan, but they gave them effort in order to launch our new global parenting support policies that includes also non-traditional family. So for us, build a safe environment, also psychological, also from the psychological point of view, is like create the ground in order to permit to the people to give to express themselves and give the best performance. I finished. I'm available on MeToo for any question, and I thank you for the time you gave me.
Mm-hmm. Dario, thank you very much.